Welcome to this video talking about the Trace32 integration to the Wind River Workbench. Since February 2016, it is possible to use the Wind River Workbench as a user interface together with the Trace32 debugger. The communication is done over the Target Communication Framework TCF. The Trace32 PowerView user interface can be started as a so-called TCF agent. The workbench can then connect to Trace32 PowerView over TCP/IP. And it is possible to access the Trace32 debug functionality from the Wind River workbench. We will be using for this video a PowerPC simulator running a VXWorks demo and a Wind River workbench version 4. So let's start. First, we need to enable the TCFC++ debugger in the Wind River workbench. To do so, we need to select the menu window Preferences, Wind River, and then Capabilities. Select TCFC++ debugger, then click on Apply. Next, we need to select in the same window Run/Debug, Launching, Launch Configuration, and make sure that the filter for the target communication framework is disabled. Lauterbach additionally offers a plugin with a simplified and adapted launch configuration. Using this plugin, it is possible to configure and start Trace32 from the workbench. To do so, click on Help, Install New Software, type the link lauterbach.com/eclipse/tcf here and then continue with the install process normally. After restarting the workbench, you should see the Trace32 TCF configuration in the debug configuration window. We will create here a new Trace32 TCF launch configuration and we will rename it to VXWorks Demo. We will then use the Trace32 tab to configure and start the PowerPC simulator. Under Paths, we can set the Trace32 working and system path. Then we will enable the TCF auto-discovery. This means that Trace32 will be automatically detected by the workbench. The port number will be also dynamically assigned. If you want to use a fixed port number, then you need to disable this option. We can then set the title of the Trace32 instance here. Using the option Run Trace32 PowerView in background, Trace32 will be started without a user interface. But we will keep this option disabled. Finally, we will select a startup script that will be executed when Trace32 is started. This script will establish a connection to Trace32 instance, loads the debug symbols and configure the Trace32 VXWorks awareness. Please note that the debug symbols have to be loaded in Trace32. There is no need to load them in the workbench. Clicking on Apply will save the configuration and we will start Trace32 using this button. Now Trace32 is started and in the Target tab we should see then the Trace32 interface under Available Targets. A double click here will display the properties of the Trace32 instance, for example the Trace32 hardware, the software version and the used target architecture. In case you have disabled the TCF discovery, you can use the new button to manually create a new target setup with the port number you have selected. We will select our target and then click on Debug. The integration provides a synchronization between the workbench and Trace32. When single-stepping the code in one interface, for instance, the other interface will follow. Variables, breakpoints, registers, and other stuff are visible in the Wind River workbench. As a demo, we will upload an RTP example using the VXDemo menu in the Trace32 GUI. Then we will start it. And here we can see in the workbench the program counter on the RTP's main function. The Trace32 interface can be terminated using the terminate button in the workbench. This is especially useful in case where Trace32 PowerView has been started in background. The Trace32 button in the toolbar can be used to relaunch Trace32. Please refer to the following links for more information about integration. Thank you for watching.